Welcome back to the Parmas Friends. In last three videos, we have covered dissolution, UV spectroscopy and IR spectroscopy. If you have not seen those videos, you can check our playlist and you can watch those videos also. So in continuation with this question and answer interview series, we are going to cover today is HPLC chromatography. So you know very well, HPLC is a very vast topic. So all entire HPLC we can't cover in this video. Some of the questions and answer I have covered in this video. So let's get start with this video. Here, first question is, what is USP general chapter number for the chromatography? So USP general chapter number 621. How many types of chromatography? So there are two types of chromatography. One is liquid chromatography and another is gas chromatography. What is the full form of HPLC? Answer is high pressure liquid chromatography or high performance liquid chromatography. Why we called high pressure liquid chromatography? Because we are applying high pressure by using a pump on the chromatography. What is the principle of HPLC? This is a common question. HPLC is a separation technique of components from the mixture by using solid stationary phase and liquid molar phase. This is a simple answer. So what is the reverse phase chromatography? So where molar phase is more polar than a stationary phase is called as a reverse phase chromatography. What is normal phase chromatography? So where stationary phase is more polar than mobile phase is called as normal phase chromatography. What is column? Column is a steel tube which contains stationary phase. What are the components of HPLC? There are six components. First is reservoir, second is pump, third was sample compartment, fourth is column compartment, fifth is detector, and sixth is recorder. What are type of detector used in the chromatography HPLC? UV detector, PDA detector, fluorescence detector, conductivity detector, refractive index detector, and a light scattering detector. These are six different types of a detector used. So what is gradient probe? Gradient run or gradient program. So mole phase composition varies over a runtime. Here example is given 1 to 4 minute. So A component is 30, B is 70, A is 40, 60. Then third minute 50, 50, fourth minute 60, 40. If you see here, every minute gradient is changed. What is isochromatic gradient or isochromatic run? So mole phase remains constant throughout the run. From 1 minute to 4 minutes, runtime will be the same. Mole phase will be same. So what is the linear gradient? Mole phase remains same throughout the run by using two different reservoirs. Example is from 1 minute to 4 minutes. Composition A and B are given 30-70, which are not changed till 4 minutes. So what is the retention time? It is the time between injection and the appearance of the peak maxima. What is the retention time? What is the relative retention time? It is a measure of difference of affinities of two compounds for the stationary phase. I hope you understand this definition. Which standard we use for the HPLC calibration? Kaplan standard we use for the HPLC calibration. Why Kaplan standard use for the calibration? So it is very stable, it is durable, it is readily available in the market, and it shows 2 maxima and 1 minima at 205, 273 and 245 nanometer respectively. So what is most commonly used in the stationary phase? Silica gel is most commonly used in a stationary phase. Why silica gel used in the stationary phase? Answer is silica gel is inert material and does not react with the mobile phase. That's reason silica gel is used. Explain the flow diagram of the HPLC system. First is solvent reservoir to store mobile phase. Second is pump to move mobile phase in a pressure. Third is degasser to remove dissolved air. Fourth is mixing valve to mix mobile phase. Fifth is guard column to protect column. Sixth is sample injector to insert sample. Seventh is column to separate components. Eighth is detector to detect the components. Ninth is recorder to record the analyzed data. Tenth is outlet to collect the waste. See you soon in the next video. Next video will be on CAPE autotractor. I hope you enjoy this series and thanks for watching this video. Best luck and have fun.